Jacksonville, Florida.
My name is Chet Frith. I did 22 years active duty in the Navy. My lungs were impacted from this last deployment. I was exposed to chemical exposure during my time in Iraq, severely impacted my lungs to the point where I likely require a lung transplant at some point.
Rockville, Maryland.
My name is Wanda Grover. I am a United States Army veteran, and I served from 1974 to 1979. I joined the military as a WAC, which is Women's Army Corps, before they allowed women into the regular Army. I sustained a couple head injuries. I started losing my vision in the 90s, the late 1990s, and then I saw the dog users. So I applied for and I went to the Seeing Eye in New Jersey, and I got my first Seeing Eye dog. He was supposed to work for 10 years. In the latter half of his ninth year, he got cancer. So I didn't go back after that. I just picked up the cane and kept going.
Tampa Bay, Florida.
So my name is Stephen Bars. I joined the Army when I was 17. I am surprised at the impact that it has on me. I can't go on a road trip without checking the tire pressure on all my cars, making sure everything is ready to go. And that's something I learned in the Army. I specifically learned from Sergeant Lance. Sorry, I gotta stop.
Whatever time you need, Steven.
Sergeant Lance was a huge influence, and he unfortunately took his life about a year and a half ago. Super sad.
Durham, North Carolina.
My name is Shaka Khan Lee, and I served in the Army.
So I was whirling PT at Fort Bragg, and all of a sudden, I couldn't breathe. I started getting dizzy, started seeing stars, and next thing I know, I was in an ambulance. I did every test possible, and everything came back negative. It pulled the fluid off my heart, which made it a little bit more room to hit the beat. But it was coming to the pulmon, it was barely beating, because it was swelling. He packed me up, he medevaced me to Duke. Yeah, after about 3 weeks, they figured out it was lupus. So it's like a test. If you have like 11 out of the 14 possible symptoms, they pretty much give you the diagnosis.
They give you the lupus diagnosis.
We're really driving a phrase that I brought to the organization called embrace the red. When people come with a problem, I want them to say, you know, we screwed this one up and we're going to figure out how to do it differently in the future. That's a really important cultural change that we're driving.
This is my second time through pulmonary rehab. You know, Veterans Affairs has been very supportive in me going through pulmonary rehab because it has shown success in you know, prolonging me keeping the lungs that I was born with, even though they are failing. The hope is that through this pulmonary rehabilitation, I'm able to maintain them longer than would traditionally without the treatment. So that's the hope, is to prolong the lungs that I was born with. We know that they're not gonna last forever. But the longer I can last with these lungs, through treatment and medication and follow up with my doctors, that, you know, I'll be able to hold on to these lungs a little bit longer than originally anticipated.
I use the VA for all my medical needs. I use technology for everything. The change to telehealth, the change to video conferencing was amazing. It helped. I don't think I've been to a meeting of veterans where I have not touted that you need to go in there and look. You need to sign up for My Healthy Vet. You need to be able to go in there and see what else is being written.
I'll go ahead and email those labels to you.
And I think that it's valuable in that I have some ownership and some control over my medical records. And I think that's something new in this day and age.
For years, there's been a great lack of trust in the VA. And a lot of that has to do with the digital tools, the software that the VA has made available. They haven't always worked well. I've really regained a lot of trust in the VA's ability to deliver really good software that's performant, it's reliable, it's what veterans need. It works the way that veterans need it to work. It's not designed by a clinician, it's designed by veterans through usability studies, and it works.
And so really it is bringing that consumer-based life that veterans, that everybody is being presented to in their personal lives, bring that into their experience with the VA, all with the goal towards providing them better service, better meeting their needs in the way that they interact with us. In the end of the day, I care about a couple of things. I care we understand the system deeply and we are driving operational excellence.
It's more so about convenience. Technology has made healthcare benefits, the VA in general, convenient. I'm the type of veteran likes to go in the VA, get what I need, and then go back to my life, right? I like to go in, get out, I can do it online, I can do it via app, perfect. That works perfectly for my life.
So the PACT Act has a direct personal impact on me and my life. And I look back at the number of years in the making that it was and to where it came. I praise the VA and their efforts of being proactive in its implementation, proactive in the communication of the PACT Act.
This goes into more detail about the eligibility and the benefits for the PACT Act.
And proactively really engaging with the veterans, getting the word out there of what we're doing.
I really enjoy serving my country and the camaraderie of serving alongside those men and women who share the same sense of honor and of sacrifice.
I'm grateful for everything. It's really led me to where I'm at today. And I would have never known about Section 508 or the VA really had I not gone through all the experiences I have.
3 days after you're there, they introduce you to the dog. And within maybe 2 hours, you have to take the dog out to go to the bathroom, okay? I slid there crying like, I am not picking up no dog food. The rain got heavy, I picked up the dog food and kept picking up dog food ever since.
Thank you so much, Shopper. Thank you for letting us in your home and seeing just a little glimpse of your life.
You know, I will say, I don't let many people in my home. My husband's like, it's gonna change once we get the pool.